In this video, I want to give you an example of exiting a position with a single-sided stop and a single-sided limit order. The first thing we do is we want to let's assume that we're in the market. Let's get in the market with a buy market order. We're going to get in and we're going to be long the market. Now let's say that we want to take our profits once the market hits a specific price. The way we would do that is we'd use the limit order. We would come in here and we'd place the limit order above the market, and you can see it's red indicating that we would be selling, and the reason we're selling is because we're already long the market, we're already green. So let's say that we wanted to get out of the market once the market reached this price level. We would put a limit order to sell one Australian dollar limit order to go short the market, which actually wouldn't be shorting, right? It would be exiting the long position. So we have quantity one that we're long. If the market reaches this price, this limit order will take us out of the market at this price level and pocket our profits. On the other side, let's assume that the market turns around and begins to drop and we are long the market. We can use a stop order, and we can come in here with a stop order, and a single-sided stop order could be placed below the market, and this would be a stop loss order, for example, and we can place this order underneath the market, and we go ahead and hit OK. Now what this is doing is it's protecting our downside risk. So if the market turns around, goes against us and comes against us and touches this level, it will exit our position from us and reduce our stops, or what we call a stop loss. It will stop our losses if the market continues lower. And this is a stop and a limit, bracketing the market that we are long this position as a limit to take profits and a stop to protect losses.